हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू दिस कोर्स टू लर्न फ्लटर एप्लीकेशन डेवलपमेंट। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिड ऑल दिस थिंग्स। एज यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन वी हैव क्रिएटेड दिस लॉग आउट फंक्शन। सो व्हेन यूजर विल क्लिक ऑन लॉग आउट आइकन, सो यूजर विल बी ऑन वेलकम स्क्रीन। एज यू कैन सी ऑन द मोबाइल स्क्रीन हेयर वी हैव दिस वेलकम स्क्रीन एंड वी आर ऑन प्रोडक्ट पेज। वी हैव एडिड दिस फंक्शन ऑन प्रोडक्ट पेज। So we have added one icon there for logout. If any user will click on logout button, so user will be log out from application and user will be on welcome screen. So in this video, what we are going to do, we will create function for login so that user can log in again. So when user will click on login button, so user should go logged. And this, as you know already, we have created the registered function. So to create login function, what we have to do, come here and first of all let's close this product page and now open sign up screen first, sign up screen, and here you will see this registered function, and inside this by mistake we have given both same controller, email controller and email controller, which is not correct. So we have to change it underscore password controller, otherwise you will get issue during login like this password controller inside this registered function, and we are on sign up screen. So make this changing please and close this sign up. Now let's open login screen. So first of all let's import here Firebase auth dot dart this package. Then what we have to do after these controller, email and password controller here, let's create instance final Firebase auth underscore auth equals to Firebase auth dot instance. Firebase auth dot instance like this. Now we have created this instance. Now after this here let's create login function. Now so for that void underscore login, this is the name of function, and then here make it async and open curly brackets. Inside this show dialog box, and let's break this like this, and remove builder and put two round brackets and underscore, then after this of two curly brackets and put semicolon at the end. Inside this return loading alert dialog which we have created in the previous videos. And here we will pass message please wait and semicolon. Then after that here we will create one variable inside user, current user like this, then await auth, this one which we have created, this one where in our instance here, this one auth dot sign in with email and password. You will see in suggestion here this one sign in with email and password. So enter, and now let's break this code like this, and here we will be adding underscore email controller dot text dot trim, and here inside this password we have to, let's break this like this, underscore password underscore password dot text dot trim And then he put here comma, and here dot then, sorry, dot then, remove this, write here auth, open two curly braces, put semicolon at the end, and here current user equal to auth dot user, like this. And after this, here remove this dot catch error and remove this on error and put two round brackets and write here error. And after this, here open two bracket curly brackets and put semicolon at the end. And here navigator dot pop contest, this one, put semicolon. And after this, show dialog, let's break it like this and remove this builder, put two round brackets and write con, and here open one two curly brackets like this, put semicolon at the end, and inside this return message. So return will be error dialog, this one, and message will be something went wrong, like this, and put to semicolon. After this catch error here, write here if condition, if the current user is not equal to null. So if the current user is not equal to null, what we have to do? So navigator dot pop context, and after this we will set root where we have to send user. Root new root equals to material page root, this one, and remove this builder and put two round brackets and underscore inside this, and here equal and greater than. We have to send user to product page, the here, and put semicolon, and navigator dot push replacement to new root, like this. Else print error. So what actually we did here, first of all we have import this Firebase auth package, then we have created this Firebase auth instance, and after that we have created this function, the name is login underscore login, and it's color like this because still we did not use it, we have to pass it in our press button, login press button. So here we are showing dialog box when somebody will press on login button, so it will say please wait. And then we have get this variable here inside this user, and then we are creating this function auth dot sign in with email and password, so that this will be email of user which we have stored in our Firestore for authenticated, and this will be the password. And then we have here catch error, if something goes wrong we are displaying here this message, something went wrong. And if we are we have added these two condition, if else, if current user is not equal to null, so we are sending user product base, otherwise we will say error. So all these things we did here. So now come here, you want press login button, This is our login button here. So inside this on-press, we have to pass underscore email controller dot text dot is not empty and underscore password controller dot text dot is not empty. So what we have to do, we have to login user, else show dialog box, and let's break this like this and remove this right here like this and put two curly brackets and draw semicolon, and inside here return error dialog box and message will be failed. So yeah, we have created all things for our login button, and here we are saying if user fill everything, email and password, so we are going to logged in user, otherwise we will show this message failed if something empty. It's saying is not empty. If it's not empty, it's not the user did not fill anything, so it means is not empty means if user filled email and filled password correctly, so we are going to user logged, otherwise we will say please fill the information or like this failed. You can write your own message here. So I wrote here failed. So yeah, we have did we did our things now, I think, and now we are ready to check our application, it's working or not. So let's run our application. Click on run. Now we are on our splash screen and we are on our welcome screen. Now let's first register new user. Click on register. Now let's choose this image, profile image, and then choose any, like I choose this image, and fill here name SAG skills, and let's give name email address SAG or say skill, write the sk at the rate gmail.com, and let's give phone number anything and password randomly anything, and registered. And remember your password and email which you are registered here. So now registered, press registered. Now we are registered. So if I press on this button, logout button, so we will go welcome page again here. So let's press on this logout button. Now we are on welcome screen. Now login again, the same email and password which we have created right now. So click on this button, login button now. And here we have to write our email, which is sk@gmail.com. And here password. Password was 123456. And now I am going to press login, which we have created all these functions here. So now click on this login. And as you can see, we are on now product page. So our login function working perfectly. So thank you guys for watching this video. See you guys in the next video for new functions.